First of all, welcome to all fellow architects, designers, and design and construction industry professionals. I'm really glad to be part of this webinar, Relentless Pursuit of Perfection, sponsored by Philips Lighting. My name is Nirmal Mangal, as Varjan has introduced me, and I work for a global architectural and interior design firm. And I have a good fortune to lead our three offices in India, located in Mumbai, Delhi, and Bangalore. I've been very fortunate with my professional journey around the world. I've had good fortune to design projects in many countries around the world, which includes majority of my projects abroad are in the US, because that's where I lived for about 30 years and practiced there. In addition to that, I have completed projects in China, Mexico, Middle East, Europe, and certainly many completed projects in India. Throughout my career, I've been inspired and driven by my unending quest for thoughts and ideas, which we call design. I've also chosen to work with firms which I consider to be design-centric firms, and also firms who are very dedicated, meticulous, and have dogged determination to explore the varieties of aspects of design. And this kind of explains the topic of webinar, which is Relentless Pursuit of Perfection, that in my thinking, the design doesn't stop it once we share our thoughts and ideas with the client. That to me is a starting point, and as we evolve design from concept into an actual working drawing and construction drawing, with that evolution must continue on as such. So today, I'll begin with starting out with just explaining our little bit about my firm. We started out in Hong Kong about 37 years ago, and today we have 900 people in 15 locations around the world. We've completed more than 5.5 million square feet of projects in India alone. And as a global firm, we've completed projects in 43 countries around the world. We are also fortunate to have won many awards. We are ranked number 5 in workplace design and overall 13th in the world in terms of interior design firm. So, how do we define our design philosophy? One of the big differentiators that we think we have is our philosophy of inside-out architecture. And what that means is that inside-out architecture really is something that when we start the design process, we not only take into consideration the exterior of the building, but we start a design process with lowest common denominator. For example, for offices, the lowest common denominator is an individual workstation. For hotel projects, the lowest common denominator would be a guest room, and for hospital, it would be a patient bed. So that becomes a measuring stick for us to start that, and we build from there. We look at from individual to the team arrangement to the neighborhood of workstations, or an arrangement of guest rooms or arrangement of beds, into a floor design, which leads us to the stacking, which leads us to the master plan. So the end result, when we end up with the final design, it is a design that addresses not only the building exterior, but it addresses interior also. Because of our strong DNA in interior design, to us, Both of those things are extremely important to us, and they must evolve concurrently in the design process. The other thing which is unique about M Moser is that since we started our operations in India, we tell our clients that we bring global expertise, local delivery. And what that means to our client is that there are many things that we have learned during the course of our practice in many countries around the world. We are able to take lessons from them and try to integrate through our design here in India. People like me, there are many people who are expats who have lived abroad for many, many years in their career. They bring their rich experience to India, and we mold that experience in context with Indian cultural, social, and economic needs. So the result is that we have integrated the positive attributes of global design, and we bring that to not only design, but construction technology and construction methodology. The other thing that sets us apart is that we are very collaborative, and I'll talk a little bit about how we go about doing that. I'm sure you all have heard about the problem-seeking methodology of design. That methodology was coined by Bill Cardle from Houston, Texas, many years ago, in which the client becomes an active participant in the design process. And some people call it problem-seeking method, some people call it design consulting services, and some people call it strategic planning, which is what we call it in Moser. And strategic planning addresses the issues related to design concept, corporate culture, brand interpretation, intended qualitative objectives. And all those things really evolve with the pre-design process. We call it discovery, in which we are leading the client with the visioning exercise to learn their goals and aspirations of the project, and also to validate the design brief at the front end of the project. That begins to help all the design professionals. It helps us to prepare for the concept design, which is a definition phase as such. And at every stage of the project, we go through a process of validation that are we meeting our project's goals and objectives. Once we do that, we move into the design development, which is extremely important. To us, the design development is just as long a phase as concept design, because the design concepts are just thoughts and ideas. It is the design development that puts the technology in that, and that's where all the design professionals come into the picture. I'm not sure if you can see the diagram to the right, and this diagram shows our collaborative approach, in which certainly the client is the center of this entire team. It is supported by architecture, it is supported by all the professionals, including structure, MEP. And also, you will notice that lighting is an integral part of design right in the early phases of the project. And we also bring in people who are important, people who bring the branding knowledge to the project. We look into the code-related issues. There isn't anything that we don't want to explore at that stage, because once we get out of concept design, we want to make sure that all the issues that can materially affect the project are properly addressed. A few things which are important to us as a company, that we are committed to sustainable design initiative, that we have done that in many, many countries around the world. And the Sustainable Design Initiative generally has three elements which affects the bottom line. Then there are social effects, which we'll talk a little bit about that. There are economic effects and environmental effects. What we see in the effect of sustainability society as such is that in a workplace, it reduces absenteeism, it increases the productivity and health of the people who are working there, and it enhances public image. From environmental considerations, you all must have heard about reducing carbon footprint, so much so that there are buildings now which are carbon neutral or carbon positive. And then there are environmental issues or economic issues. We want to achieve economic savings by spending a little bit of money up front. If you can achieve long-term savings for a client, that certainly is much more in terms of understanding your client's needs. Certainly, we are looking at how we can reduce the overall carbon footprint. But more importantly, we also want to reduce ongoing maintenance costs and projects. And there are various means of ensuring sustainability, and LEED, which is a global organization, has set up various standards as such. And these standards define varieties of measures which addresses how a design is judged for LEED certification. There are two parallel tracks, one for the base building LEED certification, and then there is a parallel track for interior design LEED certification. M Moser is proud to say that by now we've done over 200 LEED certified projects globally. As a commitment to sustainable design, all M Moser offices are at least LEED certified. The office I'm sitting in is a LEED Gold project. So my request and suggestion to all my fellow design professionals, India is the easiest country to achieve LEED certification, so please take this social cause forward. Suggest to your clients. What I have learned is that we have been doing sustainable design because of economic needs for quite some time before it even became LEED certification process. So to achieve the basic LEED certification, there is no cost bearing, at least in our opinion, on the project. It just needs a initiative on the part of design professionals. So I hope you would take my suggestion to heart and go through that. So in order to achieve sustainable design, there are four components. First goes in the planning of how we are going to achieve that. Second is integration of LEED initiatives into the design. The third is that monitoring of all LEED certified assemblies, proper disposal of recycled products, and very careful monitoring of sustainable design construction practices, and then the occupancy, which is the post-occupancy surveys, goes with that. For last few years, we have taken up the cause of designing buildings which are healthy for its occupants, and there is an organization called WELL, which is dedicated to the occupants' health. And it's an ongoing monitoring system as such. There are seven elements of that which relates to air, water, nourishment, light, fitness, comfort, and mind. I'm very happy to share this with you. We recently completed a WELL-certified project in Pune for Citibank. This is the first WELL-certified project in India. So one of the things that you can share with your clients, this is for design professionals, is that what are the benefits of WELL certification, and especially in cases of workplace, in cases of hotels and hospitals, wherever there are occupations. So it creates a healthy environment for optimal health and productivity. As we all know that when we are feeling good, when we are feeling healthy, we tend to be more productive. So it's pretty much that. The WELL certification process, it ensures that there is clean air inside. And all those designs are based on best global practices as such. One other thing, that in the beginning, in the introduction portion, we talked about the millennial population of the workplace. Well, one of the things which is very important to millennial population is that to them, the workplace is very important, and that makes a difference between choosing one job over another. So a project or a workplace or any such occupancy which has received well certification, that becomes a tool for companies to recruit talent. And also, we've talked about that the healthiest and highly desirable workplaces are a very big consideration for people now, pretty much in all ages as such. And the well certification is also a tool for companies to attain visibility among the peers. And this is part of the CSR as well. So in today's webinar, I've selected a few projects that we have done in India and abroad. I'll start out with some architectural projects. We'll move on to interior design projects. And then I'll circle back to some of the projects which we did and how the lighting design was an integral part of our design process itself. So the first project is it's a high-rise multi-family housing project. This is located in Gurgaon, about 500 units project as such. One of the things which was paramount in this one is that we wanted to design this project pretty much along the lines of sustainability. And one of the aspects that was very important to us, recognizing that this is in India, natural light is very important. So each and every unit in this project actually faces exterior on two sides. So the penetration, as we all know, penetration of natural light is about 35 feet. Okay. If you have natural light on both sides, you pretty much have natural light in the entire apartment. We also looked at, as I shared this with you early on, that design is very, very important to us. We went through multiple options as such. One of the things that client shared with us, that they wanted to give a resort-like experience in this project. So in India, one of the challenges we face is that, next to a very nicely designed project, there may be projects which does not have great aesthetic value as such. So we created an internal value, internal aesthetics. We created a resort kind of courtyard so that all units would look down upon this resort courtyard. This project was designed with multiple types of dwelling units. The parking is in the basement plus two podium level. Above that, there are two-story duplex. We call them garden villas. Above that are apartments. And on top, and let me just point out to you, I'm just going to select the... Okay, laser actually. Let me just see. So all these units on the top, these are penthouses. They are designed in a way so that none of these penthouses overlook anyone as such. There are four towers as such, and we were able to design it in such a way that each tower has four penthouses. This is another project that we designed. This is in Hyderabad. This was designed for a pharmaceutical company. One of the things that we learned was that typically most curtain wall systems are single glazed curtain wall system, which has very little value in terms of sustainability as such. So we came up with this team that emulated their own branding. So the second skin that we designed is based on the organic formulas of pharmaceutical drugs. And that became their branding as such, and it gave them a second layer of shading through the curtain wall system. The other thing that we did in this project was that instead of going with standard parking in the driveways, these are green blocks that allows grass to grow in the glass as such. We also wanted to make sure is that the courtyard in this case is designed in such a way that it is pedestrian. Most projects that we see have a tendency that they want to bring car right to the front door. So we took the drop off to the first basement level, created a very nice area as such. But what we realized that in projects like this project, most of the staff member, they are bused to the project as such. So buses stop just outside the campus bus stop, and people walk into that. So the pedestrian movement was much more important to us than anything else as such. And also, these were the concept sketches. Certainly, whenever you have pedestrian, certainly lighting takes a very strong precedent on that. This is a project which is underway right now. This is for a software development company in Indore. This project, we were given a site which is a stone quarry, and there is a big hole over there. When we were asked to design this project, we learned that just the cost of filling the hole was about 10 crore. So we looked at designing this project, which really scares us as such. What you see a cube over here is really the headquarters, and these are phase two and phase three buildings. So what was the quarry became the lake and also the parking below that. And again, you know, understanding our clients' need, the bus stop is really on this side. When people come to the site, then this is a loggia, which is a covered walkway that people can walk to any of these three buildings without getting wet during the monsoon season as such. We also, in this project, I'll show you in the next slide, the idea there was that between these two buildings, this is a raised area where people can relax during the lunch hours, and the cafeteria was below that, right at the grade level. And the interesting part is that none of these costs are more than what people normally build. We just have to think very creatively, understand that rather than looking at site constraint as impediment to the design process, we need to look at that what kind of opportunities they bring to us. This is a project that we've done for a technology company. This is in Pleasanton, California. This is in the Bay Area. And the interesting part of this project is that this project sits just at the entrance. This was an open parking lot for them, and these are the existing building for that client. The metro station is on this side, so people come here, some of them who park here, they come across, and they wanted this to be a marquee kind of building as such. So, and this company is based, their primary focus is in cloud computing, and that explains the type of facade that we used. And certainly with the idea that it would be iconic, at the same point in time, highly sustainable. This is a fiberglass mesh facade which overlays a glass curtain wall. This is a project we looked at in Gurgaon. It's an office building, Class A office building. The things that we looked at in this project was this intended project was global companies who are coming to India. Their expectations are to give a world-class experience. At the same point of time, be economical to build. So we did fantastic cost benefit analysis of varieties of system. And one of the things that we found was that we were able to not only by optimizing the structural system, that our structural system was costing 25% less than traditional structural system. Our MEP system cost was about 20% less because of sustainable design initiative and because of some innovative approach that we did for the building design. Just the interior atrium of that. Yeah. This is a project we've done in Gurgaon. This is under permitting process right now. The client, when they came to us, the project kept evolving in terms of what the client wanted on the site, and to really wanted to give a fantastic retail experience. Now, one of the things that we all know that the shopping malls are somewhat in trouble in India. They are not doing as well. So we came up with the shopping center design, which is open to sky. We call them lifestyle centers in the US. But what is so unique about this is that this is based on the retail concept of Grand Bazaar in Istanbul. And interestingly, and it is three-level shopping center, but we were able to get retail concourse, which are the spaces or the walkways outside the retail shops free of FSI. The client was really excited about that. Compared to any other project, we were able to really leverage more than 25% to 30% additional FSI versus it. Traditional shopping mall. This project included service apartments, which is this portion, an office component, and a food court with cinemas in the background. These are some of the additional images. So as I mentioned that this is the service apartment. This block contains the movie theater, this is a small office tower, and this is the food court on top of retail. One of the things that you would notice that we've done all renderings, nighttime renderings here. And the reason for that is that we, you know, projects like this, they need to have presence not only during the daytime, they need to have presence during nighttime also. These are what I call is highway architecture. This is the highway from Delhi to Jaipur. So people need to be able to identify, it's called brand identity. And people are gravitated towards projects which are well-lit, projects which emphasizes its design not only during the daytime, but in the nighttime as well. This was a design competition we did for South Delhi Municipal Corporation, and we looked at this project. And this project, we were told by the government that they are looking at a project which is almost carbon neutral as such. So we designed a project in which the two wings of the office building, which are encased by this screen, actually. So the design of screen varies depending on what exposure it is. If it's a west side, means greater sun, that means it would have fewer holes in it versus north, where it is pretty much all open as such. The most important thing in this project is that the atrium, this is designed only with fans without air conditioning, and at least our energy simulations indicated that we would be able to achieve optimal temperature during the peak of summer. And we use water pools in the atrium with convection to achieve that kind of project as well. This is a project we've done for a retail giant called TJX. This is in UK, about 30 miles outside London. TJ Maxx is a global chain of department stores, many stores in UK, many stores in UK. Interestingly, this project site was very, very difficult site. It was an L-shaped site, and we had to come up with a plan of phase development in which we are able to grow and yet at the same point of time, the project should not look like as if it is incomplete as such. Although this picture shows the summer shot as such, but during winter time it is bloody cold and it snows everywhere. So there is a system of arcade which connects this building. This is the parking structure, actually. These two are parking structure, which connects to the main building via covered walkways. This is a project that we did for a cosmetic company called New Skin. This is China headquarters. On this project, we did pretty much everything on this project. In our Shanghai office, we do have lighting designers in-house that do lighting design as such. This is a completed picture of the project as such. What we were able to do in this project, and what you are seeing is that the corporate center where people come in to visit their offices, plus this is person-to-person marketing company. So they have very large auditorium space where they teach people how to sell their cosmetic products or such and all that. But again, you know, in China as well as in India, the brand presence is extremely important. What you see here in the picture is a logo. So during daytime as well as during the night time, the presence of the building is very, very evident. Your completed shots. Quickly, I'll just go through some quick projects. This is a corporate headquarter for a real estate company in Gurgaon. This kind of design, what I call is highway architecture, mixed-use project. Project here, first two level of conference space, next four level of office space, and then above that are residential units. So, you know, the designs that we do, they need to be not only functional. The screen in the front, it plays a very, not only the aesthetic role, but it plays the role of providing sustainability to the project. I'll show you some of the interior projects that we've done, and we'll talk a little bit about lighting as such. This is a project for VMware. About 450,000 square feet project in Bangalore, 11 floors. Interestingly, in this project, by the way, we engaged the lighting design for this project right up front as such. So what you are seeing here, this is a reception area with very robust lighting as such. One of the things that we will talk quickly about the lighting design is that lighting design really is specific to the function of the space as such. What you see on the upper left-hand corner, these are lighting for a boardroom as such, where we wanted to have a diffuse light versus a very pointed light as such, whereas in the workspace as such, this is based on providing appropriate lighting level at the work surfaces as such. This is Willis Tower Watson. This is in Thane, in Mumbai, about 130,000 square feet on a single floor plate. What you're seeing is a reception area. This area has very, very high traffic area, actually, because 1,100 people on a single floor plate. You get a lot of visitors, a lot of new employees, as such, so this place needed to be very well lit as such. We use specialty lighting to define what you are seeing. Image on the right is the cafeteria. images on the left are the collaboration areas where the visitors and their employees can collaborate in an informal basis. These are again additional images of village. This is a project we did for an entertainment company. I think most of us know with the brand name, which is in the distance as such. But one of the key things was that they wanted very, very high profile, iconic design for the reception area. These are this project is on four floors. So the lighting design varies from floor to floor. It is used not only to welcome people, but to create an identity for each floor design. And this is the cafeteria. The image on the left-hand side are those workplace areas. And again, lighting and branding becomes extremely important. This is an entertainment company. They are colorful, cheerful objects that you see bike parked in the corridor. Looks absolutely fabulous. This is Nomura Security. This is in Singapore. This is done about 4 years ago. I was there just last week and went and visited the client. They are very sophisticated firm and they wanted very subdued, subtle lighting. So the lighting is just as important as the elements that you see, which were used to build that. A lot of use of indirect lighting, a lot of use of cove lighting, as you see here. This is the collaboration area and the, they call it, not sure they call it canteen, but that's what it is. The boardroom on the lower left, the informal gathering area on upper left. This is a very interesting project. This building was an industrial building. This is in Guangzhou, Tencent. Tencent is a search engine in China. So it was adaptive reuse. We came up with ideas, the structure that you see in the middle. We built that structure as part of our design to create collaboration spaces. Very informal workplaces. This is an ideal place for a millennial to work. Again, the light sources were all indirect lighting, all diffuse lighting. That was part of the design process. And this is the cafeteria, actually. So it kind of gives an appearance of a bar. You know, the millennial, they can relate more to the bar scene. This is a project we did for a global sporting company. You can see the brand in the background. This is done in Bangalore. So wonderful office is their marketing and design studio in Bangalore. The results were just absolutely astounding. And look at the lighting that we've done. It almost gives a very theatrical lighting. And that was the intent here. And these are some of the workplaces. It's really wonderful place to work as such. We've done projects for most of the new age companies, and I call LinkedIn. Similar to that, this is LinkedIn New York. And again, the image is very, very fresh, very collaborative, very informal, very hip. That's the image that they wanted to give to this client. Steelcase, we did the showroom in Gurgaon. Those of you who are in Delhi, please go and visit that. Very quirky space, all exposed structure. Because this is about progress, this is about youth, this is about taking risk, and that's what this design was about. So just quickly a few images to show. I know that I'm running over a little bit as such, so as I talked about the themes, the theme for lighting is that the lighting design is to support the interior design. It needs to be integral to design rather than afterthought. One of the things that you will find that you may not find all the fixtures that you want for your project, and people like Felix and others can help you customize some of those fixtures as such. Even though there are many, many fixtures available, let's not forget use of natural light. We need to be thinking this is a very large project. We did about 600,000 square foot project. And these are some of the lightings that you see. You know, keep in mind, some of you may be involved in designing projects which are in lakhs of square feet. So the volumes are very big. The light fixtures need to really reflect that. And that's what we were talking about, flexibility in collaborative areas, that there needs to be a general diffuse lighting. So it's not dependent as much on the seating, and that's what it really reflects back. Certainly, this is Abbott Shanghai. Fantastic project, one of my favorite projects. And in this project, we had the opportunity to So we created this custom fixture, which is what you see right above the boardroom as well. Whereas in collaboration area, we wanted quirky diffused spotlights, and that's what you see in the timber ceiling. And on the upper left, it is an experience center, which is, and it's a play of light and shadows. This is a project in Delhi. This is for a company called Red Hat. They are software developers. They hire people from IITs and BITs and all that, very highly paid people. They pamper them a lot. They give them a lot of choices for workplace. As you see, this is a collaboration area because the workplace can take place anywhere. So the lighting is adjusted to that. If you look back in this lighting, there's a past lighting above the workstation, but the lighting in the collaboration area is the lighting that supports that kind of seating arrangement. And the other thing that we want to do, I want to share this with you, is, as I mentioned, lighting for visual interest, where we are washing the wall. We are also using the floor strips we are using to subtly light the reception desk and all that. So these are some of the ways we can create visual interest in our lighting design. This is a fantastic project we did for Larsen and Toubro. Everybody thinks of them as a conservative, age-old, very engineering type of firm. And they came to us. They started a new division called L&T Infotech, and they wanted to break the mold and give something very, very unusual. So we created this experience center for them. And as part of that, we created seven stops where the customers can come and experience what technology that they are able to develop for them. And so some of these spheres that you see, they have some of the exhibits that we have. We use open trellis to define the enclosure, not really have the enclosure, but visually define the enclosure. The overall effect was fantastic. Everyone that goes there has really been very complimentary as well. But one of the things that you notice that the lighting was extremely important in this one. I mean, we had the lighting designers involved in this project from day one. And So in this case, this is one of the staff as such where the customers sit here. We wanted to go ahead and use lighting as a feature, design feature itself. But our problem was that we needed to have a projector also. So we were not stopped by that. We said, by that, we are going to have that. We created a platform within the lighting and were able to mount the projector in that. So that kind of brings my closer to my presentation. And